Yeah. Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now. Baby, I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Baby, we took a trip and it's
Hello, we're the YS High School Steering Council, and in this video we'd like to go over the accomplishments that we've had for the first semester of the 2020 to 2021 school year, and we'd also like to cover a bit about what we're planning to do for the rest of the year.
For this video, we'll be going over the past events and the future events and the thank you and the gratifications for this year.
So for our past events, as you all know, our first Kahoot assembly was undoubtedly a success. We had over 100 students participating, and I'm sure everyone who joined had a great deal of fun. I'm sure everyone learned the fun fact about our esteemed teachers, and wow, the underclassmen are very, very misbehaved indeed.
Just like the Kahoot assembly was a success, I would say the elections were a big success too. As you can see, we have our best president, Gigi, and me, myself, as the vice president, secretary, PPA, treasurer, Jeffrey, and we have the hardworking representatives from all the classes in high school, seniors, juniors, sophomores, and freshmen. For senior class, we have Shui Bonsan and EQ. For the juniors, we have Ponte Tu and Ye Ye Pongbie. For the sophomores, we have Shui Dongri and Vivian. And lastly, for the freshman class, we have Michelle and Suleiman.
As for the future plans, Student Council is planning to host a lot of events for the student body and the faculty. Right now, our most recent event that we're hosting is the YS Live-ish that we have in collaboration with NHS this coming December 18th. There, we really hope to see a lot of the YS faculty, students, and even the alumni to perform and then showcase their talents and just have a good time before we go straight into December break. Nextly, we also like to plan like virtual spicy noodles and also virtual cake in the face so that we can still have those student council events, even though we're having online school and not really on campus right now. And hopefully, fingers crossed, if everything works out, we also are looking forward to plan the prom for this year. Something new that the Student Council is working is something called the IPC, which is basically the inter-school collaboration between other schools, which are ISY, YA, and ISM of our Student Council bodies to basically have a collaboration together. Though this is not finalized and it's still in the works, and we're just planning and kickstarting to do this thing. We really hope that it do become a success so that it's a really good thing for the upcoming Student Council members for the following years.
We'd like to conclude by thanking our advisors, Ms. Eden and Ms. Toyama, for the support they have given us, as well as the YS faculty and the students for helping our events successful. Last but not least, we'd also like to thank all the STUCO members for their hard work this semester.
Hi everyone, we're Proximity and we would like to talk about what we've done this first semester.
We have rebranded our logo by changing the colors to purple, which represents creativity and spirituality, and blue, which represents calmness. Earlier this year, we created an Instagram account to further communicate with the circle and to post tips and reminders to take care of your mental health. We're also posting more infographics on mental health scene in Yangon, such as the Suicidal Prevention September, to raise awareness on mental issues and also places on where to get help for your mental health.
So for December, we have very big plans that we're very excited to announce. Since this Christmas, we can't give our loved ones physical gifts. We would like to give an opportunity for those to give more digital-oriented gifts. So we'll be opening icon commissions through our Instagram account and taking orders to that, where customers can choose their art style they want and send the images for the artist to recreate. And payments will be collected to most digital transaction platforms. The price range is from $5 to $15. And most importantly, the purpose is to donate 100% of the profits made to Yuadaji Mental Health Hospital, where many patients are currently not receiving basic care due to COVID. So here's a little sneak peek of how things will work. As seen in this slide, the clients will send something, a picture, where they will also be given an array of styles they can choose from, which each style will also have a price point. And more information will be posted on our Instagram account soon. So once it's updated, we'll also let you guys know.
So as you can see below, these are our plans for this year. Our main end goal is to donate to the Yuadaji Hospital from the funds we've accumulated this whole year. And coming soon, we have a collab with Building Blocks to make merchandise. So stay tuned and updated. Also, we'll be interviewing some students and teachers about the mental health scenes in YS for feedbacks and opinions. And these interviews will be anonymous. Then for May, which is the mental health month, we're going to have a design competition, which will start around April. So it is ready to be announced by May. The winner of this competition will get their design placed on the merch and also get a portion of the money that is accumulated. And for the last thing, during semester two, we're gonna have this anonymous confession platform where we're gonna let people confess. And we'll make sure that this platform is a secure and safe place so people can talk about their problems without being worried about it.
Lastly, I want to gently remind you guys, get some sleep. Sleep and mental wellness are directly linked to each other. Express your feelings. Don't bottle them up. It's the stressful period for all of us. Talk to friends and family. Humans are social creatures after all. And lastly, value your time off the screen. Give your eyes a break. Thank you.
exert a wholesome influence on the school. In taking initiatives in the classroom and in school activities, the Real Leader strives to train and aid others to reach their common goals of success. The price of leadership is sacrifice, the willingness to yield one's personal interest for the interests of others. A leader has self-confidence and will go forward when others hesitate. No matter what power or resources may exist in a school, community, or nation, they are ineffectual without the guidance of a wise leader. Leadership is always needed. Thus, to lead is a meaningful and substantive charge to each of our members. A leader is best when people barely know he exists. When his or her is done, his or her aim fulfilled, they will say, we did it ourselves. Lao Tzu.
Hi everyone, my name is Kuncho.
And my name is Pinky. We are both the presidents of TEDx Yangon International School.
TEDx Yangon International School, as a team, has the mission to educate the audience with ideas that are word spreading to YS and Myanmar as a whole. The TED program is a global community welcoming people from every discipline and culture who seek a deeper understanding of the world. We believe passionately in the power of ideas to change attitudes, lives, and ultimately the world.
TEDx Yangon International School is a chapter of the TED Global Community. Our goal is to make a TEDx event happen in YS with the support of a student team.
However, this year, due to COVID-19, the event will be virtual. We have also decided on the date of April 23rd to host our virtual event.
This year, our theme is A World on the Edge as a means of retrospect and foresight. We chose this theme to convey information about the fragility of our human systems and what we can do to counteract threats to our existence. Speakers with expertise in urgent global issues such as air pollution, protection of biodiversity, social issues, and more are going to speak at our TEDx event to share their insight and knowledge to the next generation of future leaders. Now we'll be revealing speakers from our own YS community. One of our guest speakers is Dr. Page.
Our second speaker is Yeyin Pompier from grade 11.
Five more speakers from outside of our community will be revealed later on our official TEDx Yangon International School social media and from our website.
More exciting news and activities will occur in semester 2, so stay tuned for new announcements. Thank you.
Hello everyone, this is Youth Troubleshooters and we're going to today talk about our plans for semester 2 and also what we've done so far for semester 1. So unlike previous years, our focus this year is on promoting education through digital means. This is because of COVID-19. And so it's important that we spread this information digitally. So our first emphasis is on creating GIFs. So our plan here is to help students learn through visual aid, cues and aids. So what we noticed so far throughout Myanmar is that kids have to retain a lot of information through rote memorization. And in the textbooks that we have searched online, they're the official Myanmar textbooks that we have found online. We found that most of these concepts were explained thoroughly, but did not have any pictures to supplement with it. So what we're trying to do is create GIFs that will help kids learn challenging concepts and to encourage students to make associations between pieces of information and retain information quickly. So one of our focus right now is on biology. Although we aren't focused on biology, we found some concepts that were hard in the biology textbooks. And we're demonstrating here in this GIF about how organelles move throughout the cell and other concepts as well. We can see a further example here. What we try to do is try to align with the curriculum and also try to find information on the internet to ensure that our information is correct. So we've shown here some of how general organelles in the cells move around and how they look like, because in the textbook, it doesn't really show that. And we've shown animal cells and plant cells, etc., and to cover the breadth of information.
And for this, usually for the government school and schools in Myanmar, the pictures and the books are usually written in English, but we believe that using our own language to explain the concept of the learning will make it easier for most of the students. So this is the Burmese translations of most of the concept in the book, and this is the example video. And for plans for our second semester, is we are going to send these videos to orphanage, and we're going to make more of how-to videos, which is either how to draw, how to fix some things, yeah. And we're gonna start virtual fundraising events. And lastly, we're going to collab with Canoe. We're going to make a video on how to draw some specific things for the kids.
Hello, everyone. On behalf of Golden Years, welcome to our presentation. Today's agenda. We will be going over a quick recap of what Golden Years is and our mission statement, and then we'll go into our current and future events for this school year. Golden Years is a nonprofit organization that was founded to provide financial assistance and care to the abandoned elders and elderly homes all across Myanmar. Current events. Golden Years has established a Facebook page called the Golden Years Senior Society, in which members of the group publish articles and videos, basically tips and tricks for the elderly on how to stay healthy, happy, and motivated during this pandemic. Common examples of what we've created are recipes, tips on how to stay safe, corona updates, and workout videos such as yoga workouts. All of our articles are published in both English and Burmese, and our videos are published with English subtitles and a Burmese voiceover. Exercise for the elderly with a lifetime fitness class. Special thanks to Mr. Carpenter and his lifetime fitness class students. The students are currently undergoing a project in which they are creating 3 workout videos for the elderly. And these 3 workout videos are beginner, intermediate, and advanced levels. And they have different styles. So for example, some groups may have Tai Chi, others have Pilates, others have resistance training and Zumba and many more. And these workout videos will be voice-overed in Burmese and have English subtitles. And we are planning to send them to the Tawara Elderly Home, the elderly home that Golden Years has worked with for over a year. And this is going to be a fun way for the elders over there to stay fit and healthy during this pandemic. Donations towards the Dabawa Elderly Home. The Dabawa Elderly Home was infected by the coronavirus, and all of its members were unfortunately infected as well. And they don't have enough money to send the elderly to the quarantine centers. So they created their own quarantine centers within the elderly home itself. So Golden Years has donated 2 lakhs towards this foundation. We have also donated adult diapers, clothes, and protein powder towards this group. And we appreciate all the members who came out and donated these supplies. Golden Years is in the midst of creating a children's storybook with Canoe, and this is a collaboration to raise awareness about the conditions of the elderly in Myanmar. The children's storybook will be written in both English and Burmese and will be published by the end of December. And our goal is to distribute this to the local schools and orphanages within Yangon. Future events. Golden Years is undergoing a fundraising project, and the planning is already in preparation, and this will be a PUBG tournament, and this will be held during mid-February and will be open to all of Yangon. And this will be most likely during the weekend or on a 3-day weekend. And the funds will go towards the Tawara Elderly Home, the the Bawa elderly home, the one that has been affected by the virus, and other elderly homes that need help or financial assistance. TikTok competition. This is going to be a fun project that will be that will raise awareness about our group, and this is going to be for the students and teachers at our school. And what it basically is to create a TikTok, like such as singing, dancing, whatever it may be, with an elder, anybody 40 years older and above. And this is going to be published on TikTok and within our TikTok account. And the competition will begin either late January or early February. And this is a fun way to raise awareness about our group and simultaneously encourage all of the members of YIS to interact with the elders and have fun with them during this pandemic. Thank you.
Presentation from DCC. In today's presentation, we'll be talking about the past events and the future plans for DCC.
For our past events, we have collected the clothes in the last YS school year from our YS community, which is planned to be further distributed to our YS local community.
We have also done fundraising in the way of by doing bake sales, and currently we're planning to release merch.
As many of you may know, we have created a social media account on Instagram with the username of dcc.mm. We have raised awareness on a lot of issues such as air pollution, crop production difficulties, and unsanitary water in Yangon.
For the merch, this year we are planning to release at least 3 lines of items, and from the funds that we will be getting on from these merchandise, we will be directing these funds to our future events.
Of course, this year as the DCC, we are going out of our way to find an orphanage that is most convenient in location, and we're going to store all of our clothes in a safe, virus-free warehouse before going to donate it at the orphanage. And at the orphanage, we're not going to give a boring time to the children. We are going to come up with fun, interactive, efficient activities that we can do together with the children to spend a good time with them.
Furthermore, we are eventually planning to do a YS portrait. It will be a continuation of Ms. Tuman's work, where we'll collect clothes from students at YS and then donate them to the faculty and locals in the YS area. Thank you and Merry Christmas from the DCC.
This is Youth Charity Organization Myanmar, and this is a recap on our projects and programs that we did in semester one. For the first project that we did during June and July, we did COVID posters. We had content and layout teams, and we made 3 infographics to inform the online community about the COVID-19 and ways to protect ourselves from it. And it's available in both English and Burmese, which were written and translated by our members.
At the start of the new school year, YCOM had carried out a mass distribution where we gave away 100 masks to the YS community. We aim to contribute to COVID safety measures and prevent any risk at school.
And in September to October, we had a very successful Irrawaddy Dolphin fundraiser together with E360, where our members designed, produced, and took orders to raise funds to donate to the Irrawaddy Dolphin conservation campaigns.
And since our fundraisers were very successful, we caught the attention of the leader of Save the Irrawaddy Dolphins campaign. And we had 3 Zoom meetings with the campaign leader, and we talked about our donation plans, and we discussed about how we can work together in the future.
The second time we made COVID posters, we also made illustrative posters and regular social media posts during October.
Here are some pictures of the members helping out and handing out masks to the YS community.
These are the first infographics that we did during June and July. And these are the second batch of COVID infographics that we did during October. These are the illustrations drawn by our members and also written by and researched by our members.
This is a picture of our dolphin merch sales in our Facebook page, which garnered over 800,000 engagements. And we had a very successful first batch. So we decided to also extend our merch sale towards a second batch as well, which includes plushies and masks and tote bags that are pictured here.
And this is a screenshot of our meeting with the leader of the Save the ARE Dolphins campaign. And here you can see us discussing about the different sectors of how people can support the ARD Dolphins campaign.
From October to November, our layout and content teams created infographics which shared a variety of facts with the aim to share the situation of these endangered ARD dolphins to the public.
And from October to November, we carried out our fundraiser deliveries to customers all over Myanmar. And we delivered over 300 packages, and to practice safety measures, we implemented an online payment system.
And in November to December, from that delivery, we garnered all of our profits and all of our money, and we donated 9 lakhs of our profits towards the Dolphin Community Conservation Agency, particularly towards their river patrol, so that we can help their conservation efforts. And more donations will be undergoing soon as well.
For our second collaboration, we met up with Myanmar Water Portal, a representative from there, over Zoom to get advice on how we can improve our water sanitation project, Water from Myanmar, and going forward, a potential guest speaker for Win-Win State. And this Water Myanmar Portal is an independent non-government platform that provides a one-stop gateway to all Myanmar water sectors, news, business, events, and contacts and projects.
And for December, we have plans to join the ARD Dolphin Alliance that is comprised of many different NGOs and conservation groups collaborating on the awareness and protection of ARD dolphins.
In alignment with the Save the ARD Dolphins Week, YCOM posted several posters and infographics on our social media. Here are some examples.
And in alignment with our Conservation Week as well, we had a member illustrate this very beautiful illustrative poster. And then we also had efforts for people and people who have liked us and follow us on our social media pages to go and sign this petition to help save the ARD dolphins.
And these are our pictures of our deliveries that we carried out over the months. And these are the many packages that we delivered, and these are the customer reviews that we received after our deliveries. And this is a picture of the different organizations that are part of the ARD Dolphins Alliance. And after our discussions with the leader of the Save the ARD Dolphins campaign, he has notified us that if we are willing, we will be initiated into this alliance.
In our past years, we've always aligned with the SDG goals, the Sustainable Development Goals from the UN. So for this year, 2020, for semester one, we aligned with good health, clean water and sanitation, life below water, and partnerships for the goals.
And thank you for listening to our recap for our first semester, and make sure to stay tuned for our future projects, and we wish everyone a happy December break. Thank you.
Hi everyone, we're Pulse and we would like to talk about what we did this semester. So our main thing that we did was rebranding YS Pulse to Pulse. We wanted to give a more bigger, bolder personality to our editorial magazine. So what we did was We brainstormed many different fonts and color themes that could go well with us. And we decided that Futara was the best for us. So that's our new logo. And we're moving on to our Instagram account.
So for Pulse, we do have a social media platform on Instagram. And on the left, you can see our Instagram page. So on there, we would post a throwback of our old articles or just like spotlights of the any athletes or just seniors that are from YS. We also have like TikToks shared and also recipes and a lot of playlists and all the fun stuff. So be sure to check us out by scanning the code on the right. During semester one, Pulse was successfully able to publish our first issue at the end of the first quarter. So as you can see here, we have a really beautiful layout that was done by the layout team. And on the right, if you look at the top left, you would see the table of content where we have the articles listed out that were done by the writers. So we really advise you guys to check it out to know more about the seniors, freshmen, or just have fun reading about like worth it articles and all the fun stuff.
Next up, we have a sneak peek for the second issue of this year. And for this issue, we have a lot of exciting things in store for you. And we have a lot of interesting articles. And in the spirit of Christmas, we have many Christmas themed articles like every year. And some notable articles for this issue would be our articles for our food review, the voting experience of our seniors, and the promotion of the Burmese visual artist community. And as we have put a lot into this issue, we hope that you'll enjoy reading it. And as you can see here, we have this amazing Christmas theme going on. So yeah.
And if you're wondering where to go back and read all of our past issues and past articles, then fear not, because we have issue right here. So you can either go to this link here or you can scan this QR code and it will take to the YS Pulse page where you can go through all of our past issues. I personally recommend the Christmas edition of the 2019-2020 year. It's a very fun read with lots of fun articles as well. And of course, we are also beginning to accept writers again for semester two. So if you're a young writer who's very interested in developing their writing skills or working with their peers on opportunities for fun, new stuff, such as writing about food or writing about traveling or any other topic really, we're beginning to accept signups for new writers.
Quick simple update by BFB, Beagle Film Production, the Filmmaking Club. First of all, we had an acting webinar with Mrs. Natalie Krill, a wonderful Canadian actress who spoke about her career, gave tips and advice on how others can start their career too. We had a wonderful small Q&A session. This will be first of our many webinars hosted on the Win Wednesday. Due to their busy schedules, we had to postpone to mid-January. Here's a sneak peek into future speakers. We have Canadian filmmaker Mr. William Henry, with over 10 years of filmmaking experience working with companies such as BMW. Next, we have Mr. Patrick Tashidian, an Indonesian cinematographer and editor, with also 10 years of filmmaking experience. He has worked with people and celebrities such as Mr. Russell Peters and Ken Jeong, and companies such as Toyota. Here's a list of what we have accomplished this semester and our ongoing projects. We have designed and renamed our club to Bigelow Film Production in tribute to Catherine Bigelow, the first and only woman to win Oscars in directing. Next, we hosted our first successful webinar, first of many, and we have multiple projects each led by each one of our student officers. We have a film collaboration with Rice relating to feminism. We have introductory videos about our new teachers, and we are continuing our webinar program as I mentioned earlier with speakers from the film industry. And we're working on transitioning into a community service group, and we're working on creating Instagram content. And that's it. Thank you.
I'm Chelsea, the president, and our vice president is Junior. and we're going to present about what we're doing currently and what Connote stands for. So yeah, our secretary is Kent and our treasurer is Kung Cho. So we're still accepting new members. So if you guys want to join, you can still reach out and tell us.
Okay, so our mission is to spread awareness for COVID through art, provide support for communities and orphanages, and empower the youth through art and support their dreams. Okay, so our past projects include YS Got Talent, the face painting booth, Yangon Walls, and we made children books as well as bake sales and art sales. So one of our upcoming projects is Dreams X Canoe, and the goal of this project is to support upcoming artists from Yangon by providing a market for them to sell their artwork on. Any amount of money that we make through this project will be given back to the artists and to orphanages as donation.
And now we're working on a book with Golden Years, and the book illustration, it's a story about karma, and you guys will find out more when we release the book. Since we're selling it, we plan to sell it to the elementary school kids and even middle school. So please support us, and yeah, basically. And with the funds, we plan to donate it to the government schools, the orphanages, and also the nursing homes. So our future plans, what we haven't planned, yes. So we're planning on doing a COVID art contest. So people who wants to draw and who wants to participate in YS, they can do that. And we have special prizes for the winner. And this is still in the making, so we will keep you guys updated. And we also have a plan for an annual YS Got Talent that we did last year. So obviously, due to COVID, we plan to make this one like a Zoom thing. So we're still not sure about that. And donation for orphanages, children's books. That's the plan we have with Golden Years X Canoe, and we're going to have the book and we're going to donate it to the orphanages too. So that's that. And we definitely plan to make donations for COVID care and quarantine centers since it is a very vital time for COVID. Yes. And COVID patients. So merch, this is like our upcoming plan that's definitely happening in January and February. We plan on selling mugs and flasks, and on these mugs and flasks, we're gonna do our artwork too. And we're also gonna sell some handmade crafts, some baked goods like brownies, churros, like beignets, so you guys can buy them. And we're also gonna design some phone covers and art on hoodies and sweatshirts. So that's basically it. Thank you.
Meraki organization. The meaning of Meraki comes from Greece. It means to put something of yourself, such as love, creativity, and passion into your work. We chose this word to be the name of our organization because we thought that this word would perfectly represent our intention for creating this organization. Our mission statement is to provide nutritious food, resources, and school supplies to underfunded children in need locally and abroad, and especially refugee children. Our advisor is Ms. Ann Eden. Our president is Shui Yimin Za. Our vice president is Ditsar. Emerald is secretary, and Shui Yimin Za is treasurer.
During online school, we'll be setting up social media accounts. We'll sell merchandise such as t-shirts, bandanas, tote bags, hoodies, jewelries, and prints. We will also ask the kids to make art and then send them commission money from profit. We will do digital bake sales and sell gifts, for example, from Save the Children and UNHCR directly. During physical school, we will do game show nights, auction for art, activities, and etc. We'll do pet shows and all the things done during online school. For non-fundraising plans, we'll invite a guest speaker to YIS and post on social media to spread awareness.
How and where the donations will be made. Our first organization that we chose was CARE. They donate 90% of the funds they raise, which is higher than most organizations, and that was the reason. The second organization that we chose is Save the Children. Though they only donate 86% of the money they make, they have this feature called a shop gift catalog that allows us to donate specific items. Our third choice was UNHCR. They also have the shop gift catalog feature, but they have varying prices and items, and we would like to donate as much as possible. Our fourth organization that we chose is Red Cross Myanmar. They specifically donate to Burmese crises and donate 66% of the money they make. They also have a shop gifts feature like Save the Children.
What we will be providing and donating. We will be providing therapeutic food, energy dance, micronutrient-enriched paste used for emergency feeding of malnourished children or to supplement the diets. We'll also be providing animals, and animals can be sold to help pay for essentials like school and medicine or to produce food. We will also be providing school supplies such as books, notebooks, etc., and clean water with water filters, clean water kits, jerry cans, and donation to the Clean Water Fund. And there will be health care, along with hygiene kits, mosquito nets, vaccines, and other medicines. Thank you.
So here's a recap of all E360 has accomplished this semester. We started this year off with a fundraiser with Ayawadi Dolphins in collaboration with YCOM, and here are the merchandise we launched and sold to customers all throughout Myanmar. We are beyond happy with the outcomes of this fundraiser, and we are excited to donate 100% of our profits towards the conservation of these dolphins. Now we have a new collaboration with Protect, a company that produces reusable and environmentally sustainable masks. So stay tuned. Thank you so much, and please don't forget to check out our Instagram page.
Hi everyone. We're Building Blocks, and we are a student led community service group from Yangon International School. And today we'd like to go over some of the accomplishments that we've had as Building Blocks for the first semester of the 2020 to 2021 school year. The first service project that we've had this year as Building Blocks is something that we call BB Education. And from the looks of it, you can see that it's already something that we did on TikTok. So BB Education, which in Burmese is BB Pinyae, is basically to post videos on TikTok where we would teach Burmese people about like various things like English slang words and vocabulary. Our main objective for doing BB Education is to follow our mission statement of promoting education in Myanmar. This is very imperative to have during this time, especially because with COVID, we're not able to actually go to the actual campuses of the local schools in Myanmar to go and actually teach English. So this is a way for us to promote the education in the country and then actually teach something to the people of what's like a necessary thing to do. From here, you can see that on the left is our TIC code, which is basically a QR code that you can scan to access our TikTok page. And on the right, you can see that we already have 4 videos published on our page, and we actually publish them on the weekends, on Saturdays and Sundays. And right now we already have 8 members who's already worked on them, and we have all of the members that's actually been contributing to make this a success. Right now we have it on pause because of the other projects that we're doing, but we are looking forward to actually expand this and then continue this on forth.
Hello, so this is a donation to ALD Foundation by our building blocks. So on October 7th, our building blocks leaders, we decided to donate money to ALD quarantine facility that was located near our school, which is in front of our Duwena Stadium. So we donated 1 million jets to the quarantine facility because during the last few months, our corona cases in Myanmar, and in Myanmar, especially in Yangon City, has exponentially rose up, and it was like very scary for us. And I feel like we should donate to those quarantine facilities because hundreds of people go there for the treatments. And yeah, I'll cut that part out. And yeah, this is a picture of the quarantine facility inside there. So people are wearing PPE protection suits, and these are the nurses and doctors and everything.
And for our first fundraiser of the year, we're planning to hold an Among Us tourney around January 22nd. We're going to have both middle school and high school participate in this tournament. And our goal is to, since we're unable to hold in-person tournaments, I believe that we should raise money fundraised through online tournaments. It's from January 22nd, 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. And the sign-up forms, we're planning to close it on January the 1st. And with the money we get from this, we're planning to donate all of it to the Myanmar Children's Foundation. This is a nonprofit based in California, which is seeking to cultivate the future leaders of Myanmar.
And as our second fundraiser of the year, we're collaborating with Proximity to do a merch sale. And our current ideas include masks, customizable bracelets, necklaces, t-shirts, crew necks, and other clothing apparels. And these are some of the ideas we're referring to right now. So from here, I would like to thank our PP members, Mr. Montgomery, our school faculties, and everyone who have worked diligently to support Building Blocks up until now. Thank you.
Hi guys, so semester one has finally ended, and in this video, I'll be wrapping what Rice did in this semester. So we had two guest speakers. One was Ma Nenda, who is one of BBC 100 Women for 2020, and she talked about feminism and gender equality in Myanmar. And another guest speaker was Violin Bix, who is a development manager of Colors Rainbow. And Colors Rainbow is an NGO that is working to enhance understanding and acceptance of dignity and human rights for the LGBT individuals in Myanmar. So thank you all for support and showing up at our events, and I hope you all learn about feminism and the LGBT community in Myanmar from these events. And we held two girl talks. One was for high school and another was for middle school. And from these girl talk, we believe that it will mutually benefit the school community, in which women and girls get together in a safe environment to share hopes, grace, support, love, and experiences. We'll be holding more girl talks next semester, and we'll also be holding boy talk as well, so stay tuned for it. And Rise Fundraising. So we're now fundraising for Women for Justice, which is an NGO in Sagay with a purpose to promote women's rights and gender equality. So they go around the country advocating for women's rights, and they will visit homes of women and girls who are sexually and domestically abused, and they would provide basic needs for them. They also go around government schools and also educate them about the importance of advocating. And so these are the products Rice is currently selling to fundraise for Women for Justice, and we have now made over 6 lakhs selling these products. And all the proceeds will be going to Women for Justice. And RISE has also made a lot of collaborations with different clubs and community services. One was with Bigelow Film Production, where we collaborated together to make a short documentary film about feminism and its origin. At CART, they contacted RISE so that because they wanted to feature us in their Thanksgiving event, Express a Community, where we can write posts and blogs about feminism and gender equality. And also with LMB, where we collaborated together to write Feminism, the Origins, and it was posted in YIS Daily Eagle. So RISE also has its own Instagram post, and in this Instagram page, we wrote posts such as "What is feminism? Patriarchy? Why we should vote women in Bidang Zuludo?" So if you haven't, go follow it. So thank you all for all the support. We are so excited to share our plans for semester two, and have a great winter break.
Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now. Baby, I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Baby, we took a look and it's like a ghost town. Baby.
Hello, YS. We are the Environmental Community Service. Our members are Rushi as president, me, Anna, as vice president, Sulat as secretary, Hansu as treasurer, Susu as designer, and our other members are Kay and Miranda. Lastly, as our sponsor, Mr. Bowers.
These past weeks, we have been thinking about many ideas, but none of them sparked interest, and most of them couldn't even be achieved because we're online. Until after long hours of brainstorming, we got the idea of starting a business. We have been working so hard to get a successful start to our business. But why business, you may ask? Because there was no way that we could really go out and help the environment physically in that way, so we decided that we would change the mindset behind our club. We decided that we would make money and donate it to environmental centers as our game plan.
Now the big question, what is our business? Our plan is to sell art, jewelry, and depending on our profits, clothes. We are selling these materials to help the environment by donating 80 to 90% of all our profits to groups and organizations that are trying to save the environment from all the harm we are causing.
When we do launch our business, if you are someone that would love to help the environment but cannot give a full-time commitment to this club, buy our products. By doing this, you're not only getting some pretty awesome items at a cheap price, but also helping towards a big cause that isn't talked about much but needs to be a priority. Until next time, signing off as the Environmental Club.
Hello, Wyatt.
Returning respect. Group members, Mr. Brush Rader, sponsor, Siri, president, Kennedy, vice president, Mary, secretary, Sydney, treasurer, Rora, marketing, and Jewel, designer.
So for our fundraising ideas, we have planned a lot of fundraising ideas, and here are some of them. So we are planning to sell care packages with delivery, and the theme will be a cheerful theme, and also a hope you are well theme. And the colors will be based on our returning respect colors, which are gold, gray, and white. And those packages will be sent to the people who bought the packages, and if they want to send it to someone, the packages, it will be also from delivery. For our starter money, of course, we don't have any money to start with, so we are planning to contact the high school group, and then hopefully they will lend us some starter money so that we can start off with our business. And after we have enough money, we'll give them the money back.
What will we do after this virus? After this virus has slowed down, we will go and visit the elderly and spend time with them. We'll listen to their stories, share our stories, and maybe learn some life skills from them. We might also play games with them too.
So for our logo of the Returning Respect, we included an elephant in our logo because the elephant reminds us about the elders, and elephants are also very calm and they have a strong meaning in them. And also the theme is a great theme because that is what our group theme is, and the theme can remind us of the elders.
So our group is called the Animal Rescues Group.
It is a community service where we help stray animals.
These are our group members.
Miss Tishui, Mo Bibo Tiji,
Pomiet, Juno, Candy, and Mary. So, this is one poster that we made for our community service group.
What we are planning to do in this community service group, we are planning to sell food. We plan to sell American candies and food. Example, Takis, Heels, or Skittles. We will be selling these snacks when school opens again or when this corona thing has slowed down a bit.
How are we going to do to get money? We all will be putting a little amount of money together. Our group has 8 members, 9 including the teacher. If 4 people put in 5,000 chats, we will have 20,000 chats total. If 8 people put in 5,000 chats each, we'll have 40,000 chats, and that can be our starter money.
This is our logo for the Stray Animals Community Service Group.
Thank you for listening.
Perfect, you don't need no filter. Go just make them drop dead. you again.